Collaborative filtering and then content based filtering. So usually recommendations can be divided into these two types at a high level, but under each one, say under collaborative filtering, let's see. Again, there are two types. One is user based recommendations and then items based recommendations. So these are two different types under collaborative filtering. But however, content based filtering, there is not much available in Mahu. It's just like a very generic concept of content based filtering as opposed to the tough collaborative filtering where they have like user based and item based recommendations. Okay, let's try to understand, you know, the differences between all these things conceptually so that it will be more meaningful for us for further understanding. So what I would do is I'll just take some small example over here to explain you how the collaborative filtering, I mean, to explain all these different terms, what is collaborative filtering and what is user-based recommendations and item-based recommendations and the content-based recommendations. To do that, what I will do is I'll take some movie specific data set over here to explain you in a better way. Okay. So first let me take few movies over here to explain user based and item based. So movies data, say I'll take first, let's start with the user-based and item-based recommendations both, and then go back to content-based. I'm just taking a few moves over here, Sherlock Holmes. Let's see. Let me take, guys, please feel free to ping me your suggestions over here for movies. Zeros. Yes, please feel free to ping me your suggestions for movies. I don't see you, you people being very much interactive. Usually other batches, I see a lot of questions and not many, even more interactive, I suppose. Okay. X-Men. And then let me take, say, okay. I think that should be sufficient. This much is sufficient. Okay, so here let me get this. So I just randomly picked up some examples over here to explain you guys about different functions. Okay, so I just take into a sense. Okay, so consider these are, you know, different movies we have now. And based on this movie, let's start building some recommendations. So let me take users also, because whom are we going to interact? Ideally, to the users, right? I'll take Amit. And I'll take Sure. Okay, so let me also take Fatima. Okay. So I'm just taking different users also, and let's now try to apply this. Okay. So guys, so let's start with, you know, user-based recommendations first. Now I'm going to talk about user-based recommendations, how it works. So in user-based recommendations, let's say if Amit has seen Sherlock Holmes and he might have seen, you know, Titanic, and he might have liked it also, and he might have seen, say, something like Lord of the Rings, and he likes this movie also. Say he might have also seen, say, X-Men, and he likes the movie. So Amit would have seen different such movies, okay, and he might have some preferences towards these movies. Okay, we can even represent the preferences also, but at this stage, I just don't want to confuse you guys with taking all the preferences and all. Say around ratings, say just consider ratings. Amit has like rating 40.5 here, some 4.5 here, something like that. Some ratings also he has given. So assume that Amit has liked all these four movies. He has seen and he has liked all these four movies. Okay, in user-based recommendations. So generally, in user-based recommendations, what we do is, we first identify similar users. Okay, the like-minded users we'll identify first, and then we try to do recommendations based upon the like-minded users. And it will also work good, because say if you are having specific interests, people like you who are having the same interests might also see something new which you haven't seen and which will be even more interesting for you as well, since your interests actually matches with the other person's interests over here. So this, most of this kind of recommendations basically fall under, say, user-based recommendations. So let me finish up this example to give it a bit more clarity. So Parthman also has seen, say, Sherlock Holmes, and he also has seen Titanic, and he also has seen, say, X-Men. So guys, considering this scenario, like, and say Joseph has seen only like Jurassic Park, and say he has seen the Godzilla over here. So yes, Sam also has seen, say, Jurassic Park, and he would have seen some different movies, say, Lord of the Rings. So considering this is the distribution, who are the most like-minded users in this case, guys? Who are the most like-minded users in this case? So let me take this one also. Sam has seen it in Godzilla. Guys, can everyone please ping me on the chat window? With this distribution, can you determine who are the most like-minded users? Yes. So Kodan Ram says that both Amit and Parthivan has very similar interests, because both of them has seen most of the movies in common, which are like Sherlock Holmes, Titanic, and X-Men, and then they have rated almost equivalently, assuming that both the users has given pretty much the same ratings. And in the other set also, if you see, Joseph and Sham seems to be pretty much similar users based upon the movies they have seen and they have read. Okay, so in this scenario, can I be able to build a recommendations platform where, since now that I have identified the similar users like Amit and Parthivan and Joseph and Sham as the similar users, can I recommend Parthivan with any movie, guys? Can I recommend Parthivan? Yes, right, because both these guys matches, and Amit has seen additionally Lord of the Rings, so I can actually recommend Parthiban to actually watch Lord of the Rings, because here we are purely depending upon the user's tastes or user's interests. So this sort of recommendations, where you find similar users and start doing the recommendations based on other similar users, this is called as the user-based recommendations, guys. Okay, at the same time, let's try to understand the item-based recommendations as well. Okay, so to understand the item-based recommendations, I'll just clear all these different things over here. And let me take, you know, yeah, so here, let me take something like some few other movies I'll add over here to get it even more clear. Joshna, I'll talk about that. How it can be done, I'll talk later. So let's first try to understand, you know, conceptually what user-based recommendation is. I'll talk about how it can be achieved. And let me take another examples like, say, examples. I just taken another two examples over here. Guys, usually what happens is, in general, you know, users, even though user-based recommendations works pretty well, okay, because we are mining similar users and based on that we are trying to recommend the other users. Even though it works very well, still there are some backlogs in the user-based recommendations, like users' interests may not be fixed all the time. Okay, users might have different interests at different times, and your interest might change over a period of time also. So you should constantly keep changing the similarities which you have mined for the user-based recommendations. At the same time, if I come back to another sort of recommendations, which is item-based recommendations, which is an alternative for user-based recommendations, what you will do is, you will first identify similar items, okay? And then you will start doing the recommendations based on that. So in this case, say I can actually mine similar items based upon the user interests and the based upon the type of the items itself. For instance, like I can mine, you know, Tomorrow Never Dies, X-Men, and Expandables to be one similar movies, because they are all in a sort of action movies. So I can say that Tomorrow Never Dies is Godzilla and this Expandables to be same movies. Say, for instance, if I mine like these are similar movies, so let me just mark it to different code over here. This one, and sorry. If Amit sees both these movies, Amit watches both these movies, then I can actually recommend Amit, since I have mind that these three movies are similar in nature, I mean these three items are similar in nature, since Amit watched both these movies, I can actually recommend Amit for another movie, which is this Expandables, because he likes, you know, similar movies like the say action movies. So I was able to recommend Amit for this new movie, which is Expandables. So this sort of recommendations, where you first mine the similar items, and then based on the similarity of the items, you start doing the recommendations, are called as item-based recommendations. And item-based recommendations are more consistent in nature. Okay, usually items will not change, right? So if these are similar, so they will become always similar to each other. So it will never change. So that's why these are more consistent as opposed to these are best recommendations, guys. And this also works well for doing the recommendations. Item-based. So now that we understood both user-based and item-based, so let's try to understand what is content-based recommendation. So for content-based recommendation, let me just pull up, you know, few more examples in this case. So I'll take, you know, say item. So this is one, and say Sherlock Holmes 2. See, if these are different movies again, if consider that say Shyam actually has seen these movies like say Sherlock Holmes and say Iron Man, and he liked these two movies a lot, so can I recommend Shyam to have Sherlock Holmes? Okay, I can do it. On what basis I am doing this, guys? Can anyone tell me on what basis I am planning to recommend Shyam to watch actually Sherlock Holmes 2? So in this case, any answer for this? Okay, no problem. So guys, let me tell you. So here, if you look at these three movies, what is in common in these three movies? Actually, the hero within this movie is common. The lead role within this movie is in common for all these three movies. So the lead role played in all these three movies are actually Robert Downey. Okay. So here, since this guy has seen both the movies where the Robert Downey is playing the lead role, so since Sherlock Holmes 2 also Robert Downey is lead role in this movie, so I'm just based on that I'm actually doing the recommendations. Here we are not really mining item similarities, or neither we are mining user similarities. We are just based on some attribute of the item itself. What is the attribute here? Attribute is hero, which is Robert Downey. Based on that attribute, we are trying to do the recommendations to the users. Sometimes it also works very well because users might have specific interest towards the attributes of the items themselves. So doing content-based recommendations also will work pretty much fine. So if at all you do not have no historical information specific to the users or specific to the items to mine the similarities, then the alternate way to go with that is the content-based recommendations, where by looking at the attribute system, we can start doing the recommendations. So this is what, at a high level, these are three different things. One is collaborative filtering, which is both combination of item-based and user-based recommendations, and finally content-based recommendations. So guys, everyone is clear so far, right? Shall I move on? So Joshna, I will take your question later. So Joshna says, does clustering decide like-minded users? I'll talk about that later, Joshna, because that will be answered soon. Okay. So folks, see, what is a recommender? Broadly speaking, we can build a recommender either by finding questions that user may be interested in answering. Based on that questions, answer that the users like or whatever. So this is like, we are just trying to recommend questions to the users based upon the user's interest. And then user-based collaborative filtering, item-based collaborative filtering, slope-bound recommenders, and single value decomposition. So these are various types of algorithms available in Moodle, guys. Slope-bound recommenders is recommendation using low value decomposition. However, we'll look at many algorithms throughout our this module and next module as well. So today, anyhow, we'll cover the basic algorithms in Mahout. So Mahout implements a collaborative filtering framework popularized by Amazon and others. So Amazon also does, in fact, other few companies like YouTube, they also does the recommendations. Especially YouTube uses something called as item-to-item based recommendations. Nice. uses historical data like ratings, clicks and purchases to provide recommendations. User-based recommend items by finding similar users. This is often harder to scale because of dynamic nature of the users. Item-based calculate similarity between items and make recommendations. Items usually don't change much. So this is often can be computed offline. So item-based recommendations are more reliable in nature rather than the user-based recommendations because the problem is the nature of the users might change over a period of time. A slow code recommender, like a very fast and simple item-based recommendation approach applicable when users given the ratings not as the boolean preferences. So however, slow code recommender is another interesting algorithm, but somehow they have deprecated slow code recommender in 0.9, 0.8 it is still available. Yes.